2K Sports, in association with the PGA Tour, proudly presents the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. Today's coverage of the Players' Championship is about to begin. Pleased you could join us for this first round action. I'm Luke Elvey alongside Rich Beam, and here we are at TPC Sawgrass, the famous stadium course, Rich. This is a stern test for the players, isn't it?
It is, Luke. The interesting thing about this golf course is that every single shot seems to be working away from the previous shot. The tee shot, if it's a dogleg left to right, then the next shot requires a shot from right to left. It's just one of these golf courses that you have to think and pay attention on every single shot. You can't take a single shot for granted, and you certainly can't afford to get out of position because the angles on this golf course are so bizarre. Pete Dye is a genius when it comes to designing this golf course.
Well, it's all promising to be a good day. Can't wait to see what happens. And let's see what he can do here today. And Henny, what's he facing with this one?
Yeah, this breeze just starting to get up now on the course, and it's directly into the face. They've decided to club up.
That should set up another chance. Henny, you've had the chance to have a look over this one.
Setting up this putt 25 feet from the cup. He's staring down a birdie putt here.
This is buckets. And gets that putt of distance to go.
Can't birdie them all unless you birdie the first, Luke. Good start.
Well, that's worth reviewing. Let's roll the videotape.
Yeah, let's see this again. Have this one on repeat.
Currently one under for the tournament. First of our birdie opportunities comes at the second, par five.
Drive it out to the right-hand side to give yourself a good look at reaching this green in two.
That was absolutely murdered. Our man on the ground, John, he's down there. What's the news?
Hey guys, we are checking in with Colin Morikawa as he gets set for his next shot here on the 12th.
Oh, that is brilliant. A bonus birdie. And that'll be a big boost to his standings on the leaderboard. And back to the play, shall we? Going for this green in two, Rich. It's an exciting but daunting task.
The green is minuscule from back in the fairway. You know that you have a little bit room over to the left, but you're going to fall off into a low area. And if you miss it out to the right, you're going to find a very deep bunker on the right-hand side of the green. There's really no great miss around here, but if you're going to go for it, you have to know that your short game is going to bail you out no matter where you miss it.
Well, it'd be nice to make this one. This one's for eagle. Goes. Well, good move there. Anything north on the leaderboard's always pleasant.
Let's take a look at the par three third. Straight away mid iron to short iron shot.
Such a cool little par three. Love this green. There's a low section in the front and a high section in the back. And anytime they put the pin all the way in the back section of the screen, well, I tell you what, good luck on you. If you miss this green long and or left, that bunker sits some 5 feet below the surface of the green.
12 feet to the cup coming up. Ooh, nice putt to make for a birdie.
This guy is putting the lights out of it this week.
Currently 4 under for the round.
Moving up the leaderboard, I like it.
Well, the fourth is another great example that it doesn't need to be a long par four to be a testing one. This fourth can be menacing, can't it?
Par four, 384 yards from the back. A long snake-like bunker down the right-hand side to a cool little green with all sorts of movement on it. A very fun hole to play indeed.
That's tidy. Time for the second shot here at the fourth. Trying to get to 5 under with this putt.
This for back-to-back birdies.
Looking really good, this one. Well, look who's getting on a roll now. That's back-to-back birdies. And with that, he'll move to 5 under par. John, do you have any info down there?
Down on the 11th hole. This is Justin Thomas's next shot.
Come on, ball. Come on.
Oh, that had eyes for it. Lovely shot. And that will move him to 6 under par. Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. All right, Rich, the par four fifth. A strong hole, this one, isn't it?
Par four, 471 yards from the back. Drive it out to the left-hand side to give yourself the best angle for your second shot into this long, thin green.
Penny, what have they got in front of them here?
This is looking around 115 yards out.
A quality shot, that. And a chance for a spot in the top 20 on the leaderboard. Ooh, right by the hole. And that should secure the par on this one. And let's take a look at this shot from moments ago. This was his second.
Extravagant effort there by Schauffele.
Let's take a look at the leaderboard. Our current leader is enjoying a 2-stroke lead. The tee shot at the par 4 6th has changed a lot now that that tree's been taken out of the way, Rich. But what do you think of this short par 4?
Par 4, 393 yards from the back. Most players taking out a long iron or hybrid just for placement in the fairway. This green is surrounded by tall palm trees. Don't get caught out by one.
And Henny, what are you seeing down there?
This is down breeze, so it's going to be tough to stop it on this green.
Handy effort, that one. This putt coming up is for birdie. This one's online. You can mark it down. That's birdie number four today. And that will take him to six under. And stepping up the standings after that effort. As we go from a wonderful little par four, we go to a challenging, longer par four, the seventh.
Par 4, 451 yards, all sorts of danger down the left-hand side. Hit your tee shot out to the right. Second shot, find the green, two putt, and sprint to the tee on the eighth.
Yeah, you hit a beauty, didn't you? Let's pick up the action at the ninth hole. Time now for the fourth shot. Oh, yes, what a shot.
Chip in for birdie. That's always a nice feeling.
Sitting at six under for the day, making a move towards the top 20. Oh, what a lovely shot. He'll be delighted to be inside the range there. Standing over this one, and it's a very long putt.
This for a birdie-birdie run.
Oh, so close. Yeah, that looked to be a bit of a misread. You know, Luke Donald once made all 400 plus attempts inside 3 feet on the PGA Tour.
This for par.
Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. The eighth hole, a long par three stretching 240 yards at its maximum. It's no sleeper, that's for sure.
I don't find anything sleepy about this hole. The front of this green is so narrow. There's no place to land it, especially when they put the flag stick there. This hole will grab your attention, as it should, because it's a long iron to a sliver of an opening. Even when they put the pin on the right-hand side, you want no part of it. The center of the green all day long here.
Fairways and greens, easy game, isn't it?
It's amazing to see how good this player is in full flow.
Okay, Henny, what's he looking at with this putt?
They've just got to focus on hitting the back of the cup, guys. This is up the hill, bit of extra juice needed.
Oh, just missed. Well, this would be a good one to make. It's for par. And that moves them to minus six for the tournament. The final hole on the opening nine at TPC Sawgrass Stadium course, Rich, is a clever three-shotter.
Par five, 583 yards from the back. Most players will play this as a three-shotter. Just find the fairway out to the left. Second shot out to the right sets up a very simple third shot to a very narrow green. Miss it right or left, good luck getting it up and down.
Wonderfully played. from the bunker here, looking for an up and down. Rich always like going back and looking at T-Dub and some of the magnificent stuff he delivers.
Look at the touch that this man possesses.
Beamer, that was right out of your playbook. A touch of wizardry. Okay, let's get back to it, shall we? Well, this will be a big birdie here. Good putt to make. Frustrating. And this one is for his par. Well, that hole's behind us. More to play. Our current leader is enjoying a two-stroke lead. The back nine at TPC Sawgrass starts off with a shortish par four, but it really requires accuracy off the tee.
It does. I've seen a lot of players try and challenge the tee shot down the left-hand side. That's a huge no-no. Just bail out to the right, leave your second shot just a little bit further back, and you'll be rewarded with a fairly straightforward shot into a green that has some mounding, but overall fairly gentle.
Oh, absolutely flushed. This shot coming from around the 150-yard marker.
Has the wind coming right into his face.
Going with the 9-iron, I think.
This one is all over it.
That was a beauty. There's been some great play all over this course. How about this shot at the 12th?
Oh, I gotta say, this is a gorgeous thing, isn't it?
Nicely holed. And back to the course with the live action. Just 4 feet remaining between him and the hole. And racking up their fifth birdie of the day. And with that, he'll move to 7 under. Incredible. Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. There's some birdie holes out on this course, and the 11th is certainly one of those, but there are some troublesome spots if you get out of play.
There definitely is trouble, but the thing I love about this hole the most, Luke, is that there's so many different ways to play it. Most players will take driver off the tee, but from there, now it's anybody's ball game. You don't have to go for the green on the second shot. You can lay it up over the left. You can lay it up over to the right. You can lay it up long left. There's so many different ways of attacking this hole. Each individual is going to do it differently. I love the second shot on this hole.
Good shot there, Beamer. Time for the second shot at the 11th. Going with the 8-iron here.
Now this wind really starting to get up. That was well managed.
Putting for the big bird here. The birdie with big wings. That's well holed. Trailing by 8 strokes now after that hole. Well, the tee shot is all that matters on the short par 4 12th. Most players can reach the green. It's just the decision whether the player goes for it or not.
They can, but they better be aware that there's a lot of danger up there. Water left obviously is no good, but even bailing out to the right in those dunes, in the mounds, the little pot bunkers on top of those mounds. Well, forget about it. That's not a good space either, especially since the green does run pretty hard from right to left. If you want to take this hole on with driver and expecting to make three, well, you need to realize that a five and a six could be easily made as well.
Let's take another look at Tiger from earlier.
This was his third.
Great putt. This putt to get to 10 under par.
What a great opportunity here for a look at a birdie.
Looking really good. Beautiful shot. Moments like that deserve another viewing. Let's take a look at the replay.
What an amazing putt from way out.
Trailing by seven after that hole. Well, as you start to head for home here at TPC Sawgrass, you're blessed with this wonderful par 3 13th.
And this is a really cool par 3. You've got three distinct areas on the green, front right, all the way on the left-hand side, and the back right. Wherever they put the pin is going to dictate what shot shape you want to have into that green. I think it's a really cool design because it requires you to think about how you want the golf ball to land on the green and the way you want it to bounce. I think Pete Dye did a great job in designing this green.
That's a lovely putt to make for birdie. Take some pride in that one.
Kind of like it. Two in a row. He's feeling it.
Currently in a share of 11th place.
Always like to see your name moving up the leaderboard. Never a bad thing.
There's a few birdie opportunities out of the gate here on the second nine at TPC Sawgrass, but it really starts to toughen up down the stretch, starting here with a difficult par 4 14th.
Difficult tee shot on this plank, some 481 yards from the tip. You find the fairway, and you've got a decent chance of finding the green with your second shot. But if you're out of position anywhere on this hole, your number will go up exponentially.
That's not what he had hoped for, I'm pretty sure of that. Henny, how's that ball lying?
Oh, this first cut is just lovely. It's almost like fairway. No worries here. Yep, solid connection. This is looking good.
Oh, well done. It's time for another highlight. This time we head to the 16th.
I gotta say, his short game is one of the best in the game.
Well, that's high quality. I'm sure they're aiming for it, but for it to go in, that's awesome. Let's return to live play now. And this putt to move into the top 10. Get excited, this could go in. Well, what a performance, 8 birdies on the card. Oh, he'll take that and a spot in the top 10 to boot. Billy Horschel currently in the lead here. The par 4 15th again requires another strong tee shot because there's some trees in the way, Rich.
One of the more simple tee shots on the golf course, par 4, 470 yards. Just a little fade required off the tee to the fairway. The green sits up above the fairway a little bit, surrounded by a couple of bunkers, but I gotta say, I like this hole. It's straightforward, it's simple, before you head into the final three. John, give us an update. What's shaking?
Hey guys, we are checking in with Tiger Woods as he gets set for his next shot here on the 18th.
Should find the green here. And the shot will drop for birdie. What a way to sign off on a round. Okay, time to return to the action. And this shot from about 150 yards out.
Pretty good win back into the player's face.
Going with the pitching wedge here. And not a bad approach, that one, up onto the green. A couple of putts from there, and that'll be a pretty good hole. Putting for birdie. Nice judge's speed. Pretty good chance here. This one's for par. Billy Horschel is atop the leaderboard with a one-stroke advantage. As we head to the 16th tee, the famous par 5 reached the start of the gauntlet.
Fun-filled adventure waits. Find the fairway, and let's see how brave you are. Do you want to take on the second shot and try and knock it on the green? Of course you do, but watch out. Lots of water awaiting a wayward second.
Well, well played. This shot here near the 200-yard marker.
Wind is blowing left to right. Going to try and hold it against the wind.
This one looks like it'll safely make the green. Yeah, that was a safe play. What's in front of them, Henny?
Yeah, nice little 25-footer here from him. Outside chance, so it'll be good to hold.
That was a gallant attempt. And they'll tap this in for birdie. He's currently tied for seventh. All right, Rich, you've stood there, you've hit the shot. Take us through the par 3 17th.
Par 3 17th, 137 yards, island green. I've actually seen a caddy throw it onto this green, but with a golf club in your hand, can you hit the green?
This should play. A wonderful shot here at the 17th, and a chance for birdie. This putt about 11 feet in distance.
Good stuff today, especially the short game has been really sharp today.
tracking. Yeah, you like the look of that right off the blade.
Back-to-back birdies moving the right direction there, Luke.
Now six strokes back after that hole. When you feel like you've survived the 17th, you stand on the 18th tee and you think to yourself, where do I hit this?
It's just one of the most difficult, visually intimidating holes I think you'll ever face in your life. Somehow, try and hit it down the right-hand side of the fairway, keep it out of the rough, and from there, hit it out to the right-hand side of the green somehow, also keeping it out of the rough or that pot bunker short right. Listen, you'd be happy to make five here, that's for sure. Fours are magnificent. Threes are unicorns. They really don't happen that much. It is such a difficult, demanding finishing hole, probably one of the toughest in championship golf.
Nicely done. A fair bit on the line here. Spot the top five.
Rolling end to end, this looking nice.
And with that, this round comes to a close.